But the wonders of wonders that thrills my soul is the wonder that God loves you and me. I'm the Panini Memorial Koragi, and I would like to welcome you, all those that are listening from the comfort of your homes, those that are traveling in their vehicles, and those that are listening from their places outside Viti-Levu, and those in the abroad, our friends from Kiribati, all in Tuvalu, wherever you are in this globe, world that God has created. We are part of this global family. From Hope Channel in Fiji, we are broadcasting the word of the Lord. And I would like to say how much I am thrilled to welcome each one of you as we fellowship in the Spirit of the Lord. And before we proceed to our study, I would like to invite you wherever you are as we share a few moments with the Lord in prayer. Our gracious Father in heaven, we thank you for the wonders of sunset. And we thank you for your creation, Lord, that it is another beginning of a new Sabbath as we start to come together and worship you. Open our hearts, Lord, to the word and give us the message that we will dwell on in this special hour. Be with me, Lord, and be with the listeners wherever they are listening. Bless them in their homes and their families. For we ask all this in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our book is found in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. It's a well-known book, it's a well-known text, and it says here, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, Jesus Christ the same today, and Jesus Christ the same forever. So we are worshiping the unchanging God, the God that never changes. While the world is rapidly changing, God is still the same. The God of our forefathers, the God of your family today, and the God that will be worshipped in future. Revelation 1:11, this is the main foundation of Jesus when he took the Greek word as Alpha and the Omega. There is no other imaginary words that can fit in or changes the uniqueness of God. God is God. The God of today, the God of yesterday, the God of tomorrow. Are you worshiping this God? Our God made changes, but this God never changed. And we should be very thankful. There was a quote too by a well-known man, Mahatma Gandhi. And he said, I admire the sunset and the beauty of the moon. And it expands my heart, my soul, to worship the Creator. So here we are all fellowshipping in one God that we are preaching today. Colossians 1:16, he says here, if I read that book on Colossians 1:16, for by him were all things created. For by him, all things were created that are in heaven. All by him, things were created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. So we can see that everything belongs to God. When he created things, whether in up in heaven or on earth, it's all by him, because he made all those things. So we can say that he is the creator. That was yesterday. He created everything yesterday. Today, as we listen, and Paul take us to Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3, and I read, as I read this book, and we can see more about him. Who being the brightness of glory and the express image of his person and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged out sins, sat down in the right hand of the majesty on high. So here we are taken again to the same creator. It's Jesus, the Son of God. He was not created. Jesus was not created. He was God. And as a creator, today, it says that he is upholding all things by the word of his power. The eternal Son, Jesus, not only created all things by his powerful word, as it found in Psalms 33:6. He's not creating only by his word, but is now, today, as you listen carefully, upholding all things by the word of his power. Now we can note the remarkable relationships here between things and power. Or in modern scientific jargon, between mass and energy. The atomic structure of our very bodies is being held together. Your body and my body. No power that is holding them together. It is the power of God. It is the power of God that he is pulling things together, because he is the creator. And nobody can ask God who he is. Now we can go to Colossians 1:17. Know the frequent occurrence in Colossians 1:16-20 with the words all things, and by him, and in him, and by all things were created in the past by him, and all things consist in the present by him, all things that are to be reconciled in the future by him. Therefore, in him, all fullness dwells. Everything is complete in God. Name it what? He is whole. All the fullness of things dwells in this God. As in Romans 11:36, of him and through him and in him all are things. And in Revelation 1:11, because he is the Alpha and the Omega. They are all in all. What a wonderful God that we are serving. There is a word in verse 17 of Colossians 1. And he is therefore, he is before all things, and by him all things consist. So Paul here is telling us that Christ is before all things. Before the whole world was created, before things come into existence, in the beginning was God. Nothing else. In the beginning was God. And then all created beings, creatures, follows him. But here, we have the supremacy of God. He is the creator. He owns everything. And here we see that all things are before him. And it's always coming to before him, in him, by him, all things were created in the things that are to be reconciled in the future. So today, we must understand that God is a creator. Today, we must understand that he is upholding all things with a word. Without the word, nothing would have been existed, because God is the word. And God is power. By the word, Hebrews says, the word of the Lord is powerful, sharper than the two-edged sword. So here the word, God, has power to hold things up. And verse 17, he says here, and by him all things consist. Now, when you take this word consist in its original context, what does it mean? Sustain, to conserve, to keep it, to hold it together. So here Paul says, and he is before all things, and by him all things consist. And that is the Hebrew translation of the word. He says is sunistano, from which we get the word sustain. Now the things created by God are now being sustained. The things that were done before, yesterday, today, they are being sustained. Sustained means ongoing, preservation. They are conserved. They are kept. Why? Because by him all things were created in the past. By him all things consist in the present. And by him all things too are to be reconciled in the future. So our text today, Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ, the same. He cannot be different. The same yesterday, he was the creator. He was in the beginning. He created things. And in the brightness of his Father's glory, he was there. Jesus said, you never see my Father unless you see me. So God has given us Jesus to be his manifestation in his creation. And it says here that he is by him and all by him. And that consists to preserve. In him we live. In him we move. And in him we also have our being. We are here. Without him, I will not be standing today. And the last one, forever. Revelation 21:5. What it says. As you look to the last Bible text that we're going to share today, that Jesus is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. Revelation 21 talks about the last piece of he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So I'll read from Revelation 21, verse 5. And he says, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for the words are true and faithful. Jesus is coming. And he's going to make all things new. This world is going to be renewed. And God has kept his word. So it sustains us. It gives us hope. And it gives us courage. So we are ready when he comes. And I trust that this devotion, as we open the Sabbath, will give us the glimpse of our God never changes. Things are changing in this world, but God, through Jesus Christ, never changes. He is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. And we have a hope in this same God that one day Jesus is coming into the clouds of heaven. He's coming to take you and to take me to a new place. To a new place. This old world will come to its closing end. But the new world, as God has promised yesterday, he promised us today that he is coming. And let us fix our eyes upon Jesus, the author and the finisher of faith. And God will richly bless you from where you are listening in this opening Sabbath. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for bringing us this message. As we look at you, we see the unchanging God, the God that has the fullness of time with us, the God that has come down to our place and saved us from the sin of this world. And we thank you for your unchanging character. Because you love us, even though we have fallen from thy ways, you are still the same. You love sinners because they are your creatures, and you love our soul. And take our soul today, Lord, into the holiness of your hours, so we may see you more as we study more about you. Bless the hearers of the word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God loves me. The wonder of it all, just to think that God loves me. Oh, the wonder of it all, the wonder of it all, just to think that God loves me.